What's your I finally met my online friend horror story? Back during WoW's second expansion, there was this guy in my guild I'd become friends with mostly through other friends. We talked more and more over time, and became fairly close. He had this asshole roommate, and I could hear the guy sometimes, especially when something went wrong during a raid. He'd scream and throw fits. He was pretty awful sounding. My friend told me he wasn't just loud and obnoxious, but verbally and sometimes physically abusive too. I had my own apartment, so I said, you know what, come stay with me. Just long enough to get you on your feet, and into a place that's safe. He showed up at my place with a trash bag full of his stuff and a laptop. I set him up in the apartment, and started trying to help him find a job. Well, he did not want a job. He did not get a job either. He sat in my apartment, day after day, eating my food and slowly draining my savings. No matter how hard I tried to get him motivated, he would just dig in his heels, and somehow become more sedentary. Eventually I told him he had to go. I couldn't afford to keep him there. He was just couch surfing. I spoke to some people and eventually pieced together that his method of securing a new temporary place was playing on the sympathies of his friends to convince them he was in a terrible living situation. It just worked really well on me because he had that loud, obnoxious roommate to play off of. He wound up calling a nearby relative to come and get him, I think his aunt. I don't know what he told her I supposedly did, but I have never seen a more venomous look from someone in my life. As far as I know, he moved in with his sister and brother-in-law after that, but frankly I don't care where he ended up. He also stole a bunch of my stuff. First and last time I do anything like that. Met this dude on EverQuest, and we've played games together ever since. Been a part of the same guild, help each other out on mobile games, and have conversations about life in general. It isn't him that's the horror story, it was his mom. So one day, I think we were playing WoW at the time, I log on to do some quests. Suddenly his user comes on, and asks to chat by video. We've done this before, and there's no problem, but after I click to start the video chat, there's his mom, but naked on the screen. She asks me to watch her masturbate, and I'm like, no lady, this is just awkward af, and I log off for a few days. I get an email from my friend, and he wants to know why I haven't shown up for quests or anything. So I tell him what happened, and he is seriously like, WTF. Turns out his mom had been doing this to a lot of his online buddies, and she eventually goes to prison for raping a minor or two. Bud is doing great though, wife and kids, plus we still play the occasional game together. I never actually met the guy, but spoke to him on the phone. We'd met on MySpace when I was in college, and exchanged email addresses when we realized we lived in the same town. Eventually, I gave him my phone number and made plans for him to call me. When he did, his voice creeped me out. It was how I imagined a serial killer would sound. By the time I got past it and was comfortable talking to him on the phone, I started noticing other red flags. Whenever I brought the neighborhood up, he changed the subject. At one point, I asked him what his favorite restaurant on the boulevard was, and he hedged, so I made up a restaurant that I said was my favorite. He immediately said that was his favorite too, and that he especially loved one of their dishes. He went on and on about this wonderful place that didn't exist, and there wasn't a similar one in town, so he couldn't be confused. I called him out on the fact that he'd obviously never been to my neighborhood. Turned out, he didn't even live in the same state as me. Guy I knew in college met a girl online, and spent every day talking about her. She lived about 6 hours away, so he planned to take a semester off and pursue this relationship. He got a job in her town, and asked if I'd help him move out there, since my car would hold more than he could take on a bus. I had a long weekend off and figured, why not? A road trip could be fun. I'd drive him out as a goodbye present, and the way back I planned to visit Yellowstone. Well, we arrive and it turns out he doesn't have an apartment lined up, and he found a job posting in his girlfriend's town. He hadn't actually gotten the job, or even applied yet. I make a bunch of phone calls, and find him a room to rent that will let him move in that day with just first, last, and deposit, even without a job. I'm tired and disgusted with his lack of planning, but figure it's worth staying the night and trying to end things on good terms with my buddy. Then he breaks down and confesses that he hasn't actually met this girl. The nights he spent video chatting with her were really just him watching her vlog and jacking it. They've never talked, never texted, never even emailed. Hell, he's never even left so much as a comment or like on one of her videos. She genuinely didn't, still doesn't, know he existed. His plan was to hang out at this game shop she talks a lot about until she showed up, and somehow create a relationship from that. He thought that they'd meet, and she'd fall in love with him, and move back to our college town to marry him, all before the next semester began. That didn't happen. Instead, I made my buddy buy a bus ticket for his ride back to school and left. He came back to school, and got more cringy, not less. I lost track of him after that. But did you get to visit Yellowstone on your way back? No. I was too freaked out to want to go sightsee. I just went home, worked ahead on the syllabus, and picked up some extra hours at work. I finally made it out to Yellowstone about a year later. I met a guy online, we really got on, and he came over a few times so we could hang out. I did find him attractive and tried to hint that I was into him. Note, I can't flirt to save my life. But nothing ever happened. After a few dates he suddenly vanished offline. No social media, he wasn't answering texts or emails, nothing. I thought he'd ghosted me. After 6 months he reappears. I asked him where he'd been, and he said I don't want to talk about it. A few weeks after, there was a fad where people were googling their names and posting humorous stories they had found about similar people with their name. Mine was about a ship that had my initials, and I started to Google friends' names just out of boredom slash morbid curiosity, Googled his name, and found a local news story from his area, one of those crime and courts things, that he had been done for statutory rape of a minor, online grooming, and had his computer and phone seized as evidence. When I was younger I met an online friend in a public place for the first time. He was about my age, and hadn't lied about that, so I guess I let my guard down. Anyway, after we walked for a while I noticed he had led me down a dark alley with no other people. He then looked at me, and said how he really wanted to rape me right then and there. Right after he'd said that, my instinct kicked in, and I ran as fast as I've ever run in my life, until I came to the train station. Here I jumped on the first train I saw, and got the hell away from him. This is way back in the mid-90s. Bulletin board systems were all the rage. I made friends with this guy from NC. He was friends with a bunch of us from my dorm, mostly females, which should probably have been a red flag, but I was extremely naive at the time. A couple months in, he mentioned he was coming to our state for a wedding, and asked if he could come by our college to meet everyone. It was agreed he'd sleep in my dorm room, since my roommate was almost never around. Now, there was no discussion or thought of sex, but I was pretty excited to meet this guy, and see if he was as funny and charming as he was online. Well, day arrives, dude shows up. I should mention that I and all my college friends were 18 or 19, this guy was 24, or so he said. Guy looked like, and I'm not exaggerating, a cancer patient. Pale gaunt features, long greasy pale blonde hair, except where he was bald on top, and just generally looked like he was about to die, or he was dressed as a ghoul for Halloween. He insisted on hugging all of us. I was trying to remind myself that looks don't matter, and that he was a cool guy despite his very unsettling appearance. But then, when we all started hanging out, things just got worse. He was asking really invasive questions of all of us, making weird comments to whatever was said, just all around creepy and distressing. I was sitting on the floor with another friend and actively rocking back and forth from discomfort. I lied and said I had hurt my back, and that sleeping on the floor helped, because that night he kept insisting we could share my tiny twin college bed. Nope, 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 nope. Last time I ever met anyone from that site. He and I were part of the same forum many, many years ago. He was dealing with his issues, and I was dealing with mine. I think we both went there to escape, where people wouldn't judge. Also, because we were bored. I'm not quite sure when we got properly talking. I think it's when he told a terrible joke about kipper ties. We used to share everything with each other. Over MSN I'd give him advice about his love life and he'd listen to all my fuck-ups. It took quite a few fuck-ups before we eventually met up. I think I already knew we were in love, but seeing him in person really cemented it. We decided to give it a go, even though we live 300 miles away from each other. We had a lot of ups and downs. I was distant. He lived with his ex-girlfriend for a bit, even though she didn't have a job and couldn't afford her half of the rent. The same ex-GF who I'd given him advice on, who he had nicknamed Trouble, and liked to claim she was pregnant every so often. We got over that, along with many other things, and finally moved in with each other. I thought our issues were gonna be solved when there was no distance between us. Ends up, we were just very different people who wanted very different things, and the distance wasn't gonna change that. We broke up after 3.5 years together. None of that's the horror story. Not the way he treated me, not the fact he probably cheated on me, not that I wasn't a priority, and used to cry myself to sleep. About 1.5 years after breaking up, he gets back in touch and we talk, like it was in the beginning, when we were friends. After a few weeks, he asked if I want to get back together. I said no. I told him that he'd broken my heart again. The next day, I got a phone call from his work, because I was still his emergency contact, asking me if I knew where he was, because he hasn't turned up. The police got in touch too. The last phone call that day was from his mum, to let me know that he'd killed himself. After 4+ years of playing WoW together and chatting, online and on the phone, he invited me to visit him in Australia. I figured it was safe, since I'd known him for quite a while, and had never gotten any weird vibes, no flirtation, no creepiness, nothing. 2 days into my very clearly stated platonic visit, he tried to rape me. I ditched all of my stuff, except what I had in a small duffel bag, and took off, traveling on my own for the 2 weeks until my flight home. A few months later, I received an unsigned postcard from the Gold Coast that just said, "Thinking of you," with a smiley face. Thanks for watching. Do you have an online friend horror story? Leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe.